Hey, hi, Judy Congress here, pediatric nutrition expert. And today I'm going to share a couple stories I've been getting a lot lately. It's funny how these things come in batches with feeding problems. So I'm seeing a lot of kids lately who are 4, 5, 6 years old, tremendous feeding issues. They actually don't eat. They don't have feeding skills. They don't have the skills to chew food or swallow. Some of them are coming into me already tube fed. Some of them are about to be put on a G-tube. It's really a tough situation for parents to be in, to be at that kind of end game point where you've got to put in a tube. So a couple things I want to say about that. First of all, what can you do to prevent this? Don't let your child slide all the way down the growth chart. And this is something I see so routinely, is that when I get to meet these kids and finally get to work with them, they've already been failing and faltering in their growth patterns for a long time. Usually the pediatrician or the GI folks don't do anything for parents and kids until they need a feeding tube. And the reason for that is it's pretty much that's their only tool. They don't really work with diets or gut biome or things that help your child eat. So if you're starting to think maybe my child isn't growing the way they should or gaining weight, do something sooner rather than later. And the second thing I want to mention is, as much as we all, of course, love breastfeeding, a number of these kids have been breastfed, frankly, too long. And there's nothing wrong with breast milk whatsoever. The issue in the cases that I've been getting lately is trying to do their best. Parents let the child nurse on demand, basically. So they're basically letting, say, a 3 or 4 year old child breastfeed on demand. And in a number of the cases that I've had, that has literally delayed the oral feeding for food. If they've got a disrupted biome or any issues with digestion, even the milk protein in that, in mom's milk, can be not completely well digested. These kids end up, in that case, really constipated. They tend to have language delays. And they tend to, when they do eat food, they only want other kinds of milk protein, yogurt, cow's milk, etc. So lots of signs along the way when I get to review these kids' cases. If you need help with feeding and growth and gain, check out all over my website, nutritioncare.net. There's a blog up there about underweight. There's a blog up there about milk addiction and how these kids behave and how that delays them once they're past the age of 1 or so. The trick to getting your child eating and feeding normally earlier than, and when I say earlier, I mean starting around after their first year at least, is that they have a very balanced, healthy gut biome with bacteria in it that help them digest food. And that they don't necessarily only exclusively breastfeed. I've met a number of kids in that dilemma. After a certain age, that isn't going to serve them very well. They, like I said, they can wind up with anemia, growth failure, and constipation, believe it or not. So check around my blog. If you have a question, please zap me a question on nutritioncare.net is my website, and hope to hear from you soon. Thanks.